just seemed the comfort level was not the same as we saw before. But it's off the outside of the goal on the try by Crosby, and he hangs on to this, and he was whacked at a couple of times, and Sullivan will come around. Carl is there. Sullivan wrestled along by a couple.
That's tag team Reed and Voracek, and Sullivan. Sullivan's about 165 pounds soaking wet. Voracek's probably 215.
The defensemen for the Penguins don't want to lose this faceoff, so they have peeled back. If they move in, then it comes outside, and they want the offensive zone draw.
Giroux talking to Crosby right now. A lot of John back and forth between Giroux and Crosby. Thought the other night I received a text message from Wayne Gretzky, and he was talking about the greatness of Claude Giroux in this series so far and how impressed he was with the play of young Giroux. And I think you and I and Eddie had a chance to experience it in the 2010 Stanley Cup Final. Now we got some action going behind the play with Kimmo Tiiminen and Crosby.
Giroux and Crosby are wrapped up here. Giroux without a helmet.
Crosby scoring off of the
cut, and they start letting them go.
There we go. The tag and Tiiminen going to take their helmets off. They're going to go. The tag's pretty quick. Tiiminen doesn't fight very often, but he's square. The tag can fight. I've seen him fight in junior. He can really fight, and he can switch hands, as you can see.
Boy, did he ever.
He knows how to fight, and he's strong as all get out.
About 1,000 guys played in the league this year, so that's 20% of the sample size for the whole group. Have to hand out a few. There was a time in a single referee system where the referee skated around with the clipboard to make sure that he got everything accurate.
I don't like any guy on their team there, so his glove was near me. Went to pick it up and I pushed it. So yeah, that's
because what? I'm sorry.
I don't like him.
Why don't you like him?
Because I don't like him.
I
don't
do
like.
Something I mean
I don't like any guy on their team.
Who actually fought each other in the Wild Game 3 here in this building? Start things off as the puck is deflected near the Pittsburgh net, and Crosby is back to the ice with a hard hit as Dupuis back the other way. That puck is in the glove of Ilya Brizgalov.
That's the way to start the game. Claude Giroux up against Sidney Crosby, and you want to get the fans going in your own building. Hit Crosby. That's a good, clean, solid hit. Crosby just knocking the puck ahead.
Had it knocked off his stick. He recovers and plays it out to center ice. Letang tried to hammer it back in deep. It didn't get very far. And now Jágr trying to play it ahead, but it's knocked away. Picked up here, though, by Giroux. Shot scores! Giroux just 32 seconds in!
Nobody moves on him. He creates his own time and space. Cuts back into the middle. The right-hand shot in the left-hand side.
If Cassian can do that on a regular basis, on a consistent night in and night out, he'll find a spot.
Matthew Tkachuk with a shot, and it's deflected up into the netting and draws a crowd here behind the net.
Yeah, and here's where one hit like that at one end brings a response at the other. And I mentioned Cassian because much ballyhooed in his young career is that inability to do it on an every night consistent basis. He's a big body, he's got to play physical if he wants to stay in the league. And so far, he better be careful here, or he's going to be ending up with the only one in the penalty box.
Brandon Davidson didn't look like he was wanting to get back in there. He looked like he might be hurt a little bit, but there's extra numbers here. He had to come in.
Bennett trying to jump on that puck. Off the draw, we're going to have
penalty coming up.
Tkachuk has lost his helmet, and now Cassian started swinging. Tkachuk was not ready to go, or it appeared as though he wasn't. He turned away for just a second, Louis.
Well, I got to tell you, they've been jawing all game, and Tkachuk and Cassian have had words every single time they go by each other on the bench, from the bench, and it carried on in this shift here. There was an initial penalty coming to Michael Backlund, I believe, for a trip right off of that faceoff. But then Cassian, obviously something set him off, and he decided to take matters into his own hands. and just started firing away at Matthew Tkachuk, who can get under the skin of the opponent, no question. And they still are jostling. Ever since that hit from Tkachuk, he has been all business. He's been jarring. He's been talking to the bench. And boy, I'll tell you, this one has just elevated to a point where it's ready to explode if they don't get this under control, because both teams are just irate right now.
Wouldn't get the perfect shot away, and now, more often than not, it's going exactly where he wants to.
Well, he is almost 23, Ken.
Exactly. He's grown up.
Left bomb against Lindholm. In deep for Zach Cassian. Gets bumped hard by you-know-who, Tkachuk. And Cassian's mad, and here we go. Now there's going to be penalties in the game. They've been going at each other on and off all night, and Zach Cassian is incensed.
Now, we showed earlier in the first period the one hit that knocked his helmet off, and I don't know if you could hear, but it was McDavid yelling at Cassian to have his head up, because he saw coming back from his point coverage Tkachuk coming down. And
Zach, was some of your frustration the fact that there was no penalty on that second one, that if you had looked over and saw the referee's hand in the air, things might have been a little bit different?
For sure, yeah, definitely, but like I said, there's no penalty call. I'm not crying about the hits. It's hockey, it's a game of hockey, it's rough. I thought they're a little bit on the blind side, but at the end of the day, I've laid big hits like that. I've been hit like that. But two times is more than enough. You play with fire, eventually you're going to get burned. And he messed with the wrong guy. And I don't think he realizes that we're in the same division. And have a great memory.
McDavid kicked out. Neil will step in. Guess who? Cassian and Tkachuk chatting again.
They're going to drop. Here we go. Tkachuk, Cassian. An anticipated fight. Cassian ends up with Tkachuk down. Now they're both down. Zach Cassian and Matthew Tkachuk, with 3:25 left to go in the first period, dropped the gloves.
Weathered it. Nothing happened out of the gates, and then one fight led to another one. That's a chain reaction that happens, but
down the board for Backes, over his stick, and now Seabrook back of the goal again.
Really like this line here early on. Look at Backes and Taves are going to go out. Are you kidding me? Two guys. And Backes lands some lefts and some rights, and now an uppercut by Backes. And they both have visors. They both kept them on. Oh, Backes
lost his.
Backes got it off. This is what establishes a rivalry coming back. Two great players going at it. And they're butting heads, going head-to-head. Taves centering Kane and Brouwer. And boy, is Backes ever giving it to him. Then he stops there. Taves is in a vulnerable spot. McDonald, Backes, and boys have had a heck of a game. And that just increases the intensity and the rivalry here between the Blues and the Hawks.
He gets it near the line. Runs right over Taves.
Holy jumping.
It's a breakaway. And a save by Allen on Hossa. And then Shaw the drive, and that is blocked. And a penalty called here.
What a save.
And now it's Backes and Taves involved, and everybody jumps in. Look at the American Pharaoh.
Man, and boy, what a save that is by Jake Allen with the left shoulder. A huge, oh my, the left shoulder of Taves got David Backes right on the chin.
Steen and Shattenkirk, the point men up front. Backes with Fabry and Tarasenko. Steen wanders in there. Hermelson back of the goal. Off the boards. And now a hit back of the goal. Hermelson was hit. It was Backes on Hermelson, and Taves goes after David Backes.
And Taves was the one that got the shoulder in on the head check at the end of the first period on David Backes. He will be the third man in on this one here. Taves jumps in, I would imagine, anyway. He's backing up his defenseman, Hjalmarsson, as David Backes was behind the net and drilled number four. Four went down awkwardly.
He had a great vantage point right in front of the bench.
Ovechkin with a little bit of a rough, but then Crosby gave him a shot. What Ovechkin did really wasn't out of the ordinary, but then Ovechkin grabbed Crosby from behind, and all they did was have lip service, and there's Pierre standing there right in between the benches.
And goodbye to Crosby as he heads back to the bench, and his taunting continues as they stay perfect against the Pens.
Fanned out back to him by Letang, and a shot deflected, chopped in! It looked as though Varlamov had it at the start, but it was poked home, and it's 1-0 Penguins on a power play goal. Fedorov swung it. Kozlov across and score! Ovechkin! Bill Guerin off the board. As Gonchar decides to flip one that came in front, Crosby score! 2-1 Pittsburgh! Also Fleischman and Ovechkin left side to Green on the right to Ovechkin and drive, score! Very coolly it changed. He tied it. Ovechkin a shot, he scores! A hat trick! Malkin once more. Steps and sent one across the net, mouth blocked by the defense and played off the outside of the cage. Green working for it there, out in front, Crosby didn't get it home. Another try blocked by the defense, hacked into the air, and they score with 30.4 to go. Persistence by Crosby at the net mouth as Bill Guerin reaches it, but no icing, and it is 2-0 Capitals.
As a player, you don't see like seeing a guy on their team get a hat trick. That's usually not a good sign.
With caps raining down to celebrate the Grade 8's first playoff hat trick, Crosby, the captain, approached an official to try to get on with the game.
People kept throwing hats. I was just asking if he could make an announcement to pass him stuff. I mean, the first wave came, and then I think they were all pretty much picked up, and then more started coming. So for us, we just wanted to make sure we kept kind of moving and, kept the game going while I tried to get back into it. So
the very end, and the referees didn't hear him. Here's Connor Sheary with a shot wide of the net. Crosby raced to the puck. He got slashed on the hand. Here's a chance for a two-on-one. TJ Oshie from Backstrom. Stopped by Murray. A wonderful save by Matt Murray on TJ Oshie.
Well, here's at the end of the shift. He just got slashed by Alexander Ovechkin right on the left hand. And he was laboring, coming back, handling, trying to shake it off. Yelling at the official, wanted a call, and then the frustration. You know, this has been a tough series for him. You know that you're looking to get your first goal. You're looking to be a difference maker. And at the end, the stick will not live to fight another day. Hopefully, Crosby will.
We got action here. Ovechkin and Crosby. Crosby says, why don't you fight him? Ovechkin says, why don't you fight me? Stop talking, he says. Well, it'll be fun tonight here.
Steps into the zone to Backstrom. Yeah, the Blues break it up. Oh, Petrangelo. Now we have a scrap here. Ryan Reeves is attacked by Tom Wilson. And Reeves goes down. Bit of a wrestling match.
But we have not seen Ryan Reeves go down very often. Now, not much thrown there by Wilson. The linesman says to him, you okay? He's okay. They'll go at it again, I'm sure. Latta ended up finishing his check a couple of times right there on Petrangelo on the side. And it was, first one was a little bit of a late hit. And too many men on the ice for a split second there. Now Reeves and Wilson on the far side.
And then Ott was drilled, and he's upset. Reeves in a little dance activity. Now they throw the miss down. Reeves and Tom Wilson. Reeves a couple of overhand rights. Wilson's a big boy. Reeves landed that one in the back of his head, and down goes Wilson.
What are you going to do? You! Ah! Not right!
Tommy Wilson is a target.
Wilson at center ice. He got hit from behind and knocked down by Ryan Reeves, who goes at it again.
And the two of them are standing eye to eye and pawing at one another.
Wilson's over, and Reeves dumps him.
Whoa, Wilson
Reeves
gets Reeves.
Involved with Wilson. Yeah. They're jawing at one another, a couple of helpers. 11:42, the time of Ovechkin's 20th on the season.
Ooh.
Wilson got hit again.
Yep. And I think it was Reeves that got him, wasn't it? And he's down. That hurt. And they're going after anybody that they can find there. Puck's not around Tom Wilson. Here it is. He lets it go.
Vegas,
and that's a hard
major.
Hit that throws the helmet right off his head.
Again, where when you're back in the net, you don't have to make that huge save. You don't have too far to go as a buck to have a good fight here, boys.
That's Scott Hartnell and Dion Phaneuf. We'll go at it here. Phaneuf takes a left to start, and then Hartnell tries to come up with the top of the right, and then Phaneuf gets some rights in. Hartnell tumbles to the ice, and Phaneuf gets him for one while Hartnell's back is on the ice, and that ends that fight.
Tic-tac-toe, baby. Suck it, Phaneuf. Woo!
Things got crazy in Philadelphia again. Gustafson shot, pinballs down in front. Chester Hartnell scores. Hartnell and Phaneuf are going to go after the goal.
Where really you leave your mark on an organization like he did on the ice.
Mark Borowiecki tries that centering pass and then a little contact after the play.
Well, we got the up and up at Hartnell. This has been brewing for every game, these guys right in front of me.
You're right there. Take it away, Mike.
Dion doesn't do this very much anymore, but he has definitely gotten the better. There's the dislike. They're on the ground. They're still going. That's not because it's just one of those things. These guys don't like playing against each other. And they've got history. Lots and lots of it.
Michael Backlund on the boards. Cycles it down low. Wound up sticking on the wall as Giordano got it behind the net. Time Doughty's down in behind the goal. Play continuing, and now Pearson with a big hit on Matthew Tkachuk. Drew Doughty still down on the ice.
Ooh, and there is the elbow right to the head.
Every single shift, there's no reaction from Drew Doughty. Continues to play, but right through center ice, here comes Tkachuk, and Doughty just ducks and gets out of the way in time. He spots the Flames winger, and the temperature is going to rise in this game.
That's Doughty hollering at Tkachuk at the penalty box, Kelly.
Of course, this goes back to last season.
Yes,
we all
indeed.
Remember what happened.
Absolutely. The history there. All right, Rick. So, first shift, let's take a look what happened. So, I talked about Tkachuk and Doughty. So, whistle blows, they go behind the net. Doughty falls down. He looks right at Kelly Sutherland, the official. Like, really? Seriously, you're going to fall down over that? What a fun way to start.
It's Doughty. Tkachuk went after Doughty and just missed. They gave him a whack, and Doughty gives Tkachuk a slash, and they exchange pleasantries. Didn't see much of this between them tonight, but first bit of on-ice animosity between Matthew Tkachuk and Drew Doughty.
Well, it's going to be interesting. Is Doughty going to get an extra two? I know they're both going, but I'm unsure.
Picked up by Tkachuk.
And he gets taken out. And a good check by Drew Doughty, who goes low on Tkachuk. And this is the first of Doughty and Tkachuk of any significance we've seen. And it's a giant dogpile. These guys have been pretty quiet tonight in terms of playing against each other, but it erupts here in the third period in a game that's out of reach. And it all started with that hit by Doughty on Tkachuk.
Tkachuk does have a lot of speed, and you look at the timing, just kind of cuts Tkachuk out at the knees, and then you can see Tkachuk just hanging on, and then he just goes after him, and Wagner comes in to help, and look at Giordano, just jumps right over the pile and goes after Clifford.